Alice could not believe her ears. Was she hearing this right? Her daughter was yelling at her. She was leaving again. How long would she be alone this time? Maybe a few days, maybe a week or longer. She already felt cold. And as her daughter walked out the door, Alice wondered if the neighbors could hear how she screamed for her to take her pills, to stay in the basement, and to not talk to anyone. That was last Thursday. And as she lay barely lucid on the basement floor, too weak to get up or even call for help, Alice began to wonder, could this be it? Or could there be help out there? If you suspect a vulnerable adult is being abused, neglected, or financially exploited, call the Minnesota Adult Abuse Reporting Center at 1-844-880-1574. You could make the difference. That's the power of could. Call 844-880-1574.
The world is changing. Are you listening? Fox News updates every half hour. This is TwinCitiesNewsTalk.com.
11:30 a.m.
Because you deserve the truth. TwinCitiesNewsTalk.com.
Found smoking a cigar. I'm Dave Anthony, Fox News. And then Roddy Prince ran, but he didn't get far. A suspect in shootings in two states was captured after he threw his gun away.
I'm very happy the way this ended, because I talked about a person that's capable of shooting six people, three to dead right now.
Wilmington, Delaware Police Chief Robert Tracy Prince is accused of shooting five co-workers in Edgewood, Maryland, then driving 55 miles to a used car lot in Delaware, where police say he shot and wounded a man he'd had disputes with in the past. The manhunt for Prince, a felon with 42 arrests, lasted more than 10 hours. ISIS may have been driven out of its capital in Syria, Raqqa, but the acting head of Homeland Security tells a British newspaper that terror group and others are still hoping for another 9/11-style attack in addition to small-scale plots. Elaine Duke says they want to take down airplanes. President Trump continues to push back on a Democratic congresswoman's claims he was disrespectful, calling the widow of a soldier killed in an ambush in Africa earlier this month.
President Donald Trump strongly disputes the claim of Florida Democratic Congresswoman Frederica Wilson, who says the president told a fallen soldier's wife that he knew what he signed up for.
Didn't say what that congresswoman said. Didn't say it at all.
Wilson has said she stands by her comment and says others heard it as well.
That's Fox's Gernal Scott. The father of another slain soldier says President Trump, in a call to him, offered a $25,000 personal check, but he never got it. The White House has pushed back, saying the check was sent. Today, the president will meet with Federal Reserve Chair Janet Yellen, whose term expires in February. She could continue in that job, but the president is also considering other candidates. And thousands more wildfire evacuees have been back home now in California's wine country. Those flames burned down some 6,000 homes. 42 people were killed. Fox News, fair and balanced.
I'm Chris Addison. Here's a look at the roads. Being brought to you by the Exergen Temporal Scanner Thermometer. Looks like the traffic's moving fine this morning. No problems anywhere on the system as you're making your way around town for the early Thursday morning commute. Looks like no accidents or stalls, and of course, no congestion out there as well. We'll start off on eastbound 94 coming in Highway 101 up in Rogers on your way into Maple Grove. That continues from Maple Grove into downtown Minneapolis. Currently, it's 46 degrees. Your next report is in 14 minutes on Twin Cities News Talk, AM 1130.
The Exergen Temporal Scanner Thermometer is doctor recommended and backed by more medical studies than any other thermometer. Get yours at your local club warehouse and other fine retailers today.
Exergen is caring for your family.
From the Cremation Society of Minnesota Weather Center, sunny and warm again today. 72 in Minneapolis, St. Paul, and Arden Hills. 73 in Savage today. Wind will be south at 5 to 15. Clear tonight, 52 tomorrow. Sunny, a little breezy with a high right around 78. I'm meteorologist Sean Cable on Twin Cities News Talk, AM 1130. Currently, it's 44.
The Minnesota Gophers play Illinois Saturday at 2:30 on FM 100.3 KFAN The Fan. Warner Stellion Appliance, proud supporter of Gopher Athletics on iHeartRadio.
Next episode of the Thrive Global Podcast, Ariana Huffington sits down with television and film actor Ted Gould.